The Sony cinematic Spider-Man universe that doesn't have Spider-Man in it. What a wild ride it's been so far. Couple of crappy Venom movies, Madam Web, we all love. We all know it, we all love it. Morbius, it's Morbin time. And now it's Kraven time. Christmas is just around the corner, fam. And I hope you saved some of your hard-earned cash not for presents under the tree, but one for your eyes and ears to watch, your senses to discover anew, a new type of superhero, an anti-hero. One of Spider-Man's fiercest enemies, a foe like no other. Didn't really work, but we'll keep going. I'm talking about Let There Be Kraven. It's Kraven time. We have a Kraven the Hunter 8-minute, I guess we'll call it a teaser, for the full movie that you can see December 13th. Don't have to find it under the tree. It's going to be at your local theater. Sony's expecting big things from this. It's rated R. It's grisly. It's got Aaron Taylor Johnson, and all of his abs have been invited to the party. And I'm going to break down this 8-minute video they released of the first 8 minutes of Kraven. Let's get into it. As I go over what I can only imagine will be a cinematic tour de force, if you wouldn't mind forcing yourself on that subscribe button and the notification bell. That was a weird way to ask you to subscribe, but we're already here. Let's keep moving past it. I would appreciate it as I post movie reviews, commentary, live streams, a lot of different things every single week. Would love to have you stick around. All right, let's get into this. The film opens with a beautiful set of logos, followed by Mother Russia herself in all her pain and anguish and glory. We see a prison convoy moving down the road. They stop for a quick piss break, and there he is, the man, the myth, the legend himself, Kraven. He's known simply as 0864. Or is he? We're going to find out at the end that it's not even him. I can't wait to see more of this film. No, but seriously, before I dive further, I want to say I watched this thing, and I was honestly kind of into it. I know, it's insane to think, because I pretty much think all the Sony Spider-Man Cinematic Universe non-Spider-Man movies are shit, but this one does look a bit more promising. It's wild to even say that out loud, but here we are in 2024, on the cusp of 2025, and Sony might have made something that's at least halfway respectable. Kraven heads to prison, where he sees his cellmate. Andy Dufresne was a tall drink of water, and so is this gentleman. Kraven says, listen, bro, I'm only going to be here trace days tops. Kraven's super strong. He's super fast, super sexy, super awesome. It's recess time at the prison. Kraven's doing some weights. A couple fine gentlemen come over, inform him that this is their little playground area. K-Dog is like, listen, guys, I'm lifting my weight. You can go fuck yourselves. He pardon my French, but that's basically what he says. Tells him to piss off. They decline, they put down all their weight, they put down all their might on this guy, and with the power of 1,000 gods, K-Man pushes against them, lifting not just the massive amounts of weight, but also these two hot dogs, throws them aside, takes their heads, bashes them into the goddamn bar. It's awesome, it's a cool scene, and we're already getting a little sneak peek at what this guy brings to the table, which is raw brute force, strength, animality, sex appeal, fierceness, everything your mom loves about a man. It's coming to you in theaters December 13. After crippling a couple of guys, the guards bring him into a room where we see the warden. This warden's, he's a tough cookie. He's also a bad guy. He's been giving guns out to a bunch of different militia groups, and they've killed hundreds and hundreds of people, countless people. In the next scene, Kraven takes the saber-toothed tiger tooth, rips it out, takes out two guards, and then stabs it right into the freaking warden's neck. Blood is spraying out. This is an R-rated, edgy, hardcore, sexy Kraven, the likes of which we've never seen before on the big screen. This is going to be a problem, though. How's he going to get out of this one? Well, turns out it's actually going to be pretty easy. He pops out a window. Parker posies up the side of a wall, flips around Chun-Li-style bird kicks into the air, runs across the rooftops, couple guys up top trying to snipe him. He makes his way into the courtyard. Another dude, who has the aim I do in a round of Fortnite, can't hit shit. He's running around, spider monkeys up the side of another wall. He's one step removed from Halle Berry's Catwoman in terms of physicality and CG awesomeness. Not gonna lie, it actually looks pretty cool at points. Yeah, somewhat silly as he's Tony Hawking through the snow like Disney's Tarzan, but he's making it work. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you. They said this is the first 8 minutes of Kraven. Not buying it. If it is, there is a very poor cut coming up. We go from the shot where the guys are like, he's getting away, to a very stark change of scenery. It looks like night has turned to morning. We have a side shot where he's running into a massive storm. Where are the guards? How did he lose them so easily? Did they not have vehicles? It was a little odd. So I'm guessing they did a harsh cut here. We're missing some probably cheesier scenes where he takes out a couple guys on snowmobiles. I'm looking for wolves. I think there's going to be some wolves in this because we were foreshadowed within the first couple minutes that he won't survive an hour outside in the harsh weather with the wolves. This was cut. I'm calling it right now. He gets onto the helicopter, pops the T. We see all the little Taylor Johnsons lining up in the stomach area. We end on the guards finding a body, recovering one from in the snow. And his name is 0864. Not his real name. That's just what they call the prisoners. They give them numbers. At first, I thought his name was 0864. But then I thought, wait, that's weird. I only know like a 0855. And my neighbor down the road's a 0826, but like 0864, that's silly. That's not a real person's name. But no, what happened was K-Man, he took the identity of this person so he could get into prison purposely, assassinate this dumb fuck, and then get out of Dodge. It was the perfect crime. And it was perfectly executed. And that's Kraven, 8 minute version, the 8 minute cut. I really hope it's not the best 8 minutes. But even if so, I found myself having an all right time watching it. I thought, you know what? This is actually respectable. Way more than anything Sony's put out recently. So, all right, I'm in. What else do you have? Wow me some more. And those are my thoughts. Let me know yours. Are you in more? Are you invested? Do you think it was wise for Sony to release this Sony cinematic Spider-Man universe that doesn't have Spider-Man in it villain arc movie 8 minute teaser? Put it in the comments below. Please like the video again. Think of subscribing. Force yourself, as I stated earlier in a weird way. Force yourself to subscribe. Hit the notification bell. Short for notification bell. And hopefully I'll see you next time. If you love what I'm doing, you've been here for a while, you can become a Patreon at patreon.com/AdamDoesMovies. Hopefully as I get this video out the door, the Cyber Monday deal has still spilled over and you have a chance to go on patreon.com/AdamDoesMovies and get 30% off pretty much every tier level for the entire year. It's a great, like going into next year, not just for the next couple weeks. It's a good deal. It's a great deal. And I hope to see you around. Take care.